timing in times like these. Little you damage me.
Lots of things new at present. New Taylor Swift, new haircut, lots of new things.
But for today's video, something not so new.
So I'm starting a monthly book club.
My book club announcement video.
Hello, everyone.
Mainly because I love books.
Hello, Sunshine Book Club.
I think this is our fifth live show.
Book clubs may have been invented as early as 1634, and of course the phenomenon/trend exists to this day. Whether that be individual book clubs, Reese's Book Club, whatever the Juan Bush's daughter's name is, book club, is it Jenny?
Yeah.
Book clubs are a wonderful way to build community around books. They're a good way to just make friends and have fun, and they're also a good way to hold yourself accountable for your reading, whether that be quantitative or qualitative. Because while book clubs can serve either, I think they tend to serve both. You read more when you're reading with other people, and your reading experience might be enhanced by the conversations you all will have. So I'm absolutely no expert on book clubs. In fact, I don't think I've been to a book club meeting in a solid 1 to 4 months, but I am in a book club. And we've lasted longer than a year, which is bravo. Also, this video was requested by one of my longtime viewers, so of course I had to make it. And maybe eventually I'll do a part 2 on the phenomenon of celebrity book clubs. But for today, I just thought we'd have a simple sit-down video. I'll give you some tips on how to start your own book club if you so wish. Just talk about my own experience with book clubs and send you along your merry little way. While I think it's valid to critique book clubs, especially in the context of buying a bunch of books and branding books with book club stickers, such as Reese's Book Club, I generally think they're good. They're not a primary source of evil in this world. We have a lot more to worry about, like the ocean being on fire while an almost trillionaire goes to space. Alright, the history of my book club. My book club is called Shelf Indulgence, and I started it with some friends from my old school that I went to freshman year. And it actually was a product of quarantine. We were all really bored, didn't have much to do, and Sophia, who is the president of our book club, reached out to all of us, asked if we'd be interested, and we started a book club via Zoom. Essentially, the idea is we wanted to really focus on reading books from a wide range of authors, specifically women and BIPOC authors, and we wanted to be able to discuss the books casually, but also maybe go a little bit deeper if we so wished. We also did a bunch of other fun things, like we'd finish the book and then we'd do like a Netflix watch party, which is like super cute and fun. And then we do Secret Snowflake / Santa in the wintertime, which is really, really cool because we like, for the most part, live pretty far away, so it's fun to transport the gifts and surprise people. Here is the general layout of our book club meetings / discussions / planning. This has gotten a little warped by the school year, but we effectively meet every other week to discuss the book / set new deadlines. If you can't make a meeting, no big deal. We catch you up via text messages. Group texts are very helpful at times. And our conversations actually tend to be a lot more relaxed. I know that there are specific book club questions a lot of the time in the back of books, like book club guides. I think that's great, but I think it's also more fun to investigate a book on your own terms and talk about things that you were individually interested in and see if other people picked up on them. I think my favorite book we all read together would have to be Murder on the Orient Express by Agatha Christie. It's really fun to read a mystery because, like, you all, for the most part, if you're staying on track, are at the same place, you have the same information, and with that information you can suspect / deduct what you will. It was just a jolly, jolly fun time. I really enjoy book club, and for me, it has to be something that I'm not super stressed out about, so that's part of the reason, again, that I really like our relaxed feel. I love reading. I never want to make reading feel like a chore, and sometimes it does, so I have to take a break. But the way we structure book club, it always feels fun. So here are for you some definitive tips. Number one, assign roles. This has been really helpful for us. For example, one of our book club members, Lorelai, who is just the best ever and like an incredible artist, is our book title comer-upper. Lorelai kind of picks and chooses books that sound interesting, and then Sophia, our president, puts them all in a Google form, and then the Google form is sent out. And we vote on a book. But something that's helpful is before we even have Lorelai go and find books to add to the list, we talk about how we're all feeling and what mood we're in. It can also be helpful, I think, to have themes. So I've seen a lot of other book clubs do this, where they'll do Black History Month or Asian American Pacific Islander Heritage Month or Pride Month as their theme for that month, and then read around those months, those events, those celebrations of culture and identity. I've also actually seen people do themes surrounding color. So for example, they'll read a bunch of green books like physically green books or pink books or orange books, and I just think that's adorable. And I think that if I ran a book club that did that, it would have to be called The Reading Rainbow. I can't go anywhere. Yeah, did you grow up with that? I don't know, I did. That was like the best. That and Bill Nye, the Science Guy.
What I'm saying is the planet's on fucking fire.
It's also absolutely crucial, perhaps more so than picking books, to figure out a time slash date slash location that works for all of you. Throughout the pandemic, we met via Zoom and Mondays worked for us after school. This was because my district had remote school on Mondays and their district had remote school all days of the week for most of the year. Of course, availability would shift and we'd revolve around that. Evolve, that's the word I'm looking for.
Grow the fuck up. You're not children anymore. I didn't mind explaining photosynthesis to you when you were 12.
We try to meet bi-weekly, but what I'd say is it's key to never miss a month. If you miss a month, it's super easy to let things kind of spiral out of control. It's easy to forget what you're reading. It's easy just to lose track of that consistency. But with vaccine rollout, things are opening up again, and it could be really fun to do an in-person meeting. I have this awesome dream of us doing a meeting at like a Barnes & Noble or an independent bookshop with a cup of coffee, you know, and just having fun with it. You can create whatever environment feels good for you guys. As for talking about books, I've mentioned that I really like a relaxed kind of go with the flow, stream of consciousness, kind of schedule, kind of organization to book club meetings. However, it can be helpful to have specific questions planned out, and that's something that our president is really good at. Sophia has a lot of really good questions that bring out really insightful and interesting responses from everybody. So it's good to have maybe a guiding list of like 3 to 5 questions, but I wouldn't say anything too extensive or specific. Because at the end of the day, you're not going to remember everything you read. It's not necessarily the best idea to have a conversation planned around a single metaphor in a 500-page book. And it's also not as fun to discuss specific details, although those can come up as you go. I think it's more fun to discuss the bigger picture, the implications of the text itself, how it impacted you on a deeper level. And it can almost be more fun if you didn't like it. We read Wuthering Heights recently, and I just think it's hilarious. Like, everyone is so angsty and mad all the time. And that was just something that we all laughed about. Also remember, guiding questions a lot of the time are available at the end of books or online. Sometimes publishers put together lists, other book clubs publish their guiding questions, what they talked about, so never be afraid to look for resources on the internet or elsewhere. Last but not least, it's important to talk about organization individually. It can be kind of tricky to keep up with a book when you have other things going on in your life, work, family, friends, school, etc. It's good to find a relatively consistent time of the day that works for you to read. For a lot of people, that's before bed. I actually prefer reading in the morning slash afternoon, but enveloping reading into your daily schedule and involving your book club book, maybe reading some other books on the side so you don't get burnt out on just one or bored, is a really good way to make sure that you'll all be on top of it for the next meeting, have a good idea of what you want to talk about, and taking notes can even be helpful, whether that's little anecdotes in the margins, annotating, or an actual physical notebook. The notes app on the phone is helpful too. At the end of the day, I think book clubs should be fun, and however you can best create an environment that will be fun and safe and comfortable for everyone is the way you should structure your book club. You can have a book club with yourself, you can have a book club with strangers on the internet, you can have book clubs at school, within your families, with friend groups, with people far away, and that's what's so fun. I just think book clubs are like the coolest ever. So if you want to start one, I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to hear how it's going for you, maybe tips that you have if you've had one for longer than I have or shorter than I have. Either way, I hope you all enjoyed this video and found it relatively helpful. Again, I'm not an expert on book clubs, but they're fun. And I like them, so maybe that gives me some ounce of legitimacy. And I will see you all next time for a fun, hopefully, video. I'm your passenger.